welcome to my channel. I'm Stephanie Cole with Stephanie Cole Over 50 Living. And today we are going to be doing a whole bunch of things with lemons. In Northern California where I live, this is citrus season. And I thought that I would do two different videos. One this week and the following week I'll be doing another one. I'm going to do the first four on today's video and they are going to be more non-cooking items. And then next week we'll be doing stuff that is more of a cooking or preserving type of items. And I'm really excited because I think they're going to be a lot of fun. First things I need to do is wash my lemons and peel some of them so I can dry them out in the oven. Going to make, I want lemon peels so that I can chop them up fine. So I'm just going to take my peeler and I'm just going to push down, but not too hard, and just get the peel. Now I'm going to zest some lemons, and these are going to go in for the scrub. If you do not have a zester and you have a microplane, you can also use that. I love the smell of lemons. Now with all of these, I will be juicing them. I will freeze them in either ice cube trays or any kind of little tray, and I can use them for when I'm cooking or if I want to just add some lemon juice to a Pellegrino. I am going to bake the lemons for 30 minutes at 200 degrees Fahrenheit, and then I will check them then. I don't want them to turn brown or anything like that, so that's where I'm going to start. In our bowl, we are going to add the zest of two lemons, and we are going to do 2.5 tablespoons of coconut oil and one, roughly, tablespoon of olive oil. I've got raw honey here, and I am going to do one big teaspoon, which is probably like a tablespoon again, of the raw honey. And we are going to use lemongrass essential oil, 5 drops, because lemongrass is pretty strong. I'm also going to be using juice of 1/2 lemon. And then we are going to add the sugar. You could use salt to make it a salt scrub. And I'm going to start off with 1/2 cup of sugar. And now we mix. Little mason jars that I'm going to use. Mentioned before that I like to go thrifting and yard sale, going to estate sales, and I collect vintage fabrics or whatever I can find. And this is part of my stash. I have a whole other box. Anyway, I have these are just so sweet, so beautiful. You know, somebody took the time to do the needlepoint. I thought that I would make my sachet using some of this. So I thought maybe this one or maybe this. So I just thought I'd show you a little bit of my secret hoarded laces. Anyway, let's get back to our project. You can just buy these little bags right here. And I will link these bags and maybe a couple of other options in my description box if you would choose to make these. So I chose this one, and I am going to first just square the fabric up. So now I have a nice square, and then I'm going to sew all but one section together, and then we can add in our sachet ingredients. So now that I have this all sewn, except for just a small little opening, I'm going to trim the excess lace off. And now we will be able to fill it. For the actual sachet, I have some lavender that I have dried. So we have the lavender that's in the bowl. I'm going to cut up the dried lemon peels. And if you're wondering why my lemon peels are so orange, it's because they're Meyer lemons. And then I'm also going to add in cinnamon sticks, because cinnamon sticks sometimes, might be easy just to break them, sometimes they are good to ward off any bugs. Sometimes you can get those little moths. Plus the whole thing's gonna smell really good. So I'm gonna add in some lemon, just 5 drops. And some lavender. Then I'm going to take a little funnel. To sew around again, just to close this off. For the tea, I have some dried ginger that I dried in the oven. We have the dried lemon, and then some chamomile that's a little bit witty, so I'm gonna have to pick out some of the stems. But other than that, that's all there is to making this tea. So it's gonna be a real fast little project. I have this chamomile, and I'm going to add the ginger. It's about 1 tablespoon of ginger, and then all of this dried lemon. This is about 2 tablespoons of dried out lemon rind. And it was 1 tablespoon of the ginger and just shy of 1 cup of the chamomile. And just mix it, and that is it. And then I'm just gonna store it in a Ziploc bag. I think we're just gonna make some tea right now. I started filming this, it has been a couple of days. This is the holiday week and between Christmas and New Year's, and so we've been on the go, and I had a fail. You know how when you think something in your head of how something should be and then it doesn't turn out? I had to think about how I wanted to do the citronella candles. When I went and dehydrated them and dried them out, of course they shrunk and they were gonna be just these itty bitty little candles, so no. So what I suggest, and this is what I'm going to do, I'm going to use the fresh peel. So you would want to do this a day or two before you had your event, your party, so that they could be out on the patio, because they're going to look really cute out there. I'm going to not just use citronella. I dried some citronella, and I have some dried bee balm, and I have some lemongrass essential oil, and I'm going to mix those 3 together. I did some research, and all 3 of those will work to repel mosquitoes. And I think it will smell better in the long run. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is we are going to cut our lemons in half. And I picked the 2 largest lemons I could find. And we're just gonna cut these in half. And we are going to scoop out all the pulp. So I have the melted wax at 180, and I am going to add the essential oil in. So I have the lemon balm and the citronella mixed together. And then I have a little bit for the top. I'm going to mix that in.